Hey guys, Carly here, and today we're doing a different video than usual because I've been into a lot of art lately and I just haven't like talked about it at all. So for Christmas, I actually got these watercolors and I'm super happy. They were like $57 and they're like, hold on, they're just so awesome. I've already opened one of them to see like, I swatched it to make like to see how it would do with my water brush and my regular brush, and so these are all the colors, and which is a lot more than than I have before, because I only had about like 12 colors, or I mean not 12, but it was, you know. So so this is a problem I wanted. It's not a problem, but this actually happened because I opened it, but I tilted it, and so like almost all of these fell out. So that's just like one thing to just remember, like if you get these, like don't tilt it or else like all your watercolors will fall out and it's not good. And what I like about this is that they give you a place to like mix these, like to mix colors and stuff, even though they give you like a whole bunch of them already. It's like 45 colors, and I used my water brush, which is this right here. You put water in it and it's basically like you don't have to dip your brush into water. It's like all the water is in the brush already. And so this is what it did with the water brush, and this is what it did with the regular brush I got from like Walmart. It's not the greatest. It's just like a regular old brush. But already what I noticed is that like there's so much more like vibrant than like what I've had before. And so this is what I did when I just like tried to fade out the color, and it's really good, and it didn't leave like any, it didn't do any weird things like I'm usually used to in my other watercolors. And then I what I did here is I laid some water down on the paper, and then I just put the color in the middle, and it like blended in so well, which I'm not used to. And so these are my other watercolors. Oh, by the way, the name of these are Winsor & Newton watercolors. And this is Praying watercolors right here, which are these. And these, they come with 16 oval palettes, and you can already see like there's a difference. Like these are so much shinier than like this one. Oh, I just pulled it out of the palette. This happened as a result of because like I dropped it out of the entire palette, so like the whole thing came out. But I don't think that's really a problem if you just don't drop it if you're just careful. There's a huge difference here. And I also saw a huge difference when I tested them out. And so I tested out mauve, I believe the color is, and the Winsor & Newton watercolors. And then I tried out, put these brushes down. Then I tried out the Violet 14 and the Praying watercolors, and they don't come out. I mean, they come out, but you know, it's like a lot harder for them to move. And these are like really shiny, and I don't know if that has like any, maybe it's like what's in the watercolor that made it so shiny. Really, I do not know. But as you can see, they don't really, I guess it's a place to mix your colors in. I guess that's why they give you this. But like I have so many more places like to mix colors in with this one. And so like the difference between the two watercolors is this one, like it was so much brighter in color, and then it was so much easier to fade out. I mean, it works, both of these work better with the regular Walmart brush. I don't know why, but like I guess the water brush, like it just waters it down so much. But with the water brush, I saw that like I tried to blend it out and it made this weird like circle thing. I don't know, like it was like more wet than the other. It just left the outline, and I didn't really like that with the Praying. And it also was harder to fade it out here, and it didn't like, I wasn't able to carry it down the page like as easy as this one. And this one just faded out so easily. And so I mean, obviously the price difference tells you that there's different qualities and different, like, I mean, so this is a good brand to start off with, which it helped me out a lot because I was able to create like some pretty good artwork with it. But yeah, since I'm a little bit more into watercoloring and all that, I think Winsor & Newton is the best way to go if you're more advanced. So thank you guys for watching this video. I might do more videos like this, maybe. We'll see though. And hopefully I'm able to create some great stuff with this watercolor palette. Okay, thank you guys for watching. Bye.